Welcome to our second Form 6 topic, Growth and Development. This is Lecture 1 by Dr. Sam. In the diagram, you see the process of growth. We are human beings. We start from when we are the infant and to adult one. This is the process of growth and development in human. In plants, also illustrated the process of growth and development. It starts from the seed germinating, and in finally it forms the matured plant. That is the process of growth and development. So what is growth? Growth is the permanent and irreversible increase in the dry mass, solid matter, and the amount of cytoplasm in an organism. Growth consists of two terms, permanent and irreversible, increasing the dry mass. What is the dry mass? Dry mass is the mass of organism when all water is taken out. When all water is taken out from an organism, example, an organism is dried in an oven, the remaining one is the dry mass, which is a correct measurement of growth. We cannot measure growth when water is present in an organism because the amount of water from one organism to another varies depending on the amount of water taken and the type of food taken by such organism. Note that the expansion of a cell when takes water by osmosis is not growth, since it is not permanent and the process is irreversible. When a certain cell absorbs water by osmosis, we know that the cell have a tendency to expand and increase in size, but this phenomena we do not term it as growth, because once the water is taken out from the cell, that cell have a tendency to return to its original size and shape. So this is not growth. The previous definition of growth is from a cell organisms which have many number of cells and they have got masses. But for uncellular organism like bacteria and yeast cells, growth is defined as the change in the population size. In unicellular organism like bacteria and yeast cell, we define growth as the change in the population size. Change in the population size means that increase of the number of cells, that is when these microorganisms divide and form many cells. In the diagram we see that initially we have three number of cells, but as time goes the number of cells keep on increasing due to cell division by binary fission in bacteria cells. That is the growth in multicellular organism, because the population size increases. Here we have few number of cells, but here we have the high number of cells, and as a result the population of organism is great. That is a growth. Note that growth can be positive or negative. Positive growth is when anabolism, which is the formation of a cell, exceed catabolism, which is the breakdown of cell materials. We know that anabolism is a formation of a cell or synthesis of a material within the cell, but a catabolism is the breakdown of a cell or breakdown of material within the cell. So when the process of anabolism exceeds the process of catabolism, this is the positive growth. And normally during positive growth there is a markable increase in size and dry mass of organism. But in negative growth, it is when the process of catabolism exceeds the process of anabolism, when the process of breakdown of a cell or the breakdown of material within the cell exceeds the process of formation of material within the cell or formation of a cell. This is negative growth, and in negative growth, no matter there is a decrease in the size of organism, that is a negative growth. For example, when a person reaches a certain age, the wrinkles start to appear on his or her face. This is negative growth, because at that period the process of catabolism exceeds the process of anabolism of development. What is development? Development is defined as the increase in the complexity of organism. Remember that we started from the single cell, and at that time, when we are single cell, we were simple organism, because we had no such system like respiratory system, reproductive system, and the other system in our body. But as the time goes, we differentiate, the single cell differentiate and continue dividing to form multicellular complex organism, having many systems and the organs work together to form an organism. That is the development. So what to note in development is that during development of an organism, there is an increase in the complexity of such organism. Development and growth occur together, because you cannot have growth without development. They occur together to determine the overall change in the shape and size of organism, and this is morphogenesis. Morphogenesis means the change in the shape of an organism, because morpho means shape. We are going to see the phases of growth. Those are steps that our body takes in order to grow. Starting with the individual cell to multicellular organism, growth occurs in three phases. So we have three phases of growth. That is, we have cell division, cell enlargement, cell differentiation. So we have three phases of growth: cell division, cell enlargement, cell differentiation. In cell division, here we see that during cell division, which is the first phase of growth, the cell divided and increase in number by the process of mitosis. We are going to see later about the detail of on how the cell divide by mitosis, which result the increasing in the number of cells in the body. After the cell have been divided, the cell are still not matured full. They're going to enlarge, which is the second phase of growth, cell enlargement. In cell enlargement, there is an increase in the size of a cell. Normal cell increase in size when it take water by osmosis. Now when water take water, when a cell take water by osmosis, the cell going to expand and increase in size, and this is termed cell enlargement. And the final process of growth is cell differentiation. That is the specialization of a cell to perform specific function. After the cell have been divided, it forms similar cells. Those similar cells are going to differentiate to form unique cells that are going to perform several functions. For example, all cells initially were similar, but as time goes, the cell going on differentiating to form, let's say, sperm cell, heart cell, and the other cell in the body. This is a process of cell differentiation, which is a specialization of a cell to perform specific function. Thank you, and this is our end of our lecture today. We are going to proceed with another lecture concerning the factors affecting growth and the process of mitosis and cell cycle.